of healthcare, or is it just hot air? The Word Doctor himself, Frank Luntz, joins us live from D.C. this morning. Good morning, Dr. Luntz. Or should I call you something else?
just call me the author of What Americans Really Want, Really.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for getting that promo buzz in there. Let's talk a little bit about the wordsmiths and how this sort of rebranding effort has been going on for the last couple of months. Now we have Nancy Pelosi not wanting to call it the public option. Shouldn't what we really call it is a government takeover of healthcare? Is that why she wants to now call it the consumer option to kind of shield that?
Well, look, a lemon is a lemon. You can call it an orange or an apple. And I have a simple question for people out there who are watching right now, what you should call it. Who created it? The public or the government? Who determines the details of what's in this plan? The public or the government? Who is promoting this plan? The public or the government? Now, she's realized that the so-called public option that she wants to call it is losing support on a daily basis. And so she's trying to change the language behind it. The problem is that the American people really don't want Washington running their health care. They really don't want Washington making the decisions that should be made by doctors and hospitals. Mm-hmm. And so she's trapped in this ideological crusade that an increasing number of Americans are opposing.
But is every American keyed in to this debate or any other debate? I mean, is it true, you're the expert on words, if you rebrand something and it just sounds a little bit better, does everyone investigate or do they hear consumer option and they think, well, that sounds pretty good?
Well, this is the one case. It's a correct assumption up until about 3 months ago when they started holding these town hall meetings. And one has to wonder, there are very few people who are listening this morning that will have the right to either read the legislation because it's not being offered to the American people, or to attend a town hall meeting hosted by Senator Connor, because the Democratic caucus has actually said to their members, don't go back. They remember what happened in July and August. They remember all the anger and the visuals, not just on Fox News, but on every newscast.
Right.
The public is saying, tell me more. I want to know the details. This is not some generic policy. This is health care. This is life and death. And Pelosi's changing of the language does not change the fact that the American people are turning against this health care package.
But it's not just health care reform, Frank. I mean, we had overseas contingency operations instead of the war on terror. We had pressure track instead of sanctions with Iran. So it seems to be this sort of rebranding effort. Do you see it that way?
I would say that they are overusing their thesaurus, but I never want to use words that I cannot spell. The problem that you've got right now is that the American people are saying, be crystal clear. Tell us what you're going to do, and tell us the consequences of what you're going to do. And so they watch this. And also, look, Nancy Pelosi's never been a great communicator. Barack Obama is. Pelosi is not. If you're going to change the language, I would suggest that it come out of the White House, not out of Congress, which has the lowest approval rating in years.
All right. Good piece of advice from the wordsmith himself, Dr. Frank Luntz, the word doctor and author of Words at Work. Thanks so much for being my guest today.
And what the American people want, really.
Call it the Pelosi. Hey, look who's here.
It's the music.